I used Plasticity 3D for a week so that you don't have to. In my experience, I found many shortcomings of the solution, because of which you should not use this program for the first time, and also compared it with the shortcomings of Blender for a better understanding. The first thing that catches the eye is a rather minimalistic interface, and its minus is the incomprehensible arrangement of tool blocks. This could be ignored, but in Plasticity there are no options to customize the interface at the angle of the user's choice. Many professionals and amateurs of 3D modeling prefer to customize the game space. However, in Plasticity the interface remains fixed, which can complicate the development process and reduce productivity. For example, for some reason, a large space was allocated for productivity, where additional tools for testing could be placed. One of the shortcomings of Plasticity is the lack of a convenient item for reassigning hotkeys. You can reassign tools depending on the window that appears on the F side and in the navigation display, which can lead to difficulties and slowdowns. The lack of convenient control settings makes the program less flexible, which makes Plasticity a less attractive program for modeling. Another disadvantage of the settings is Plasticity, which does not have the ability to select a graphics core for rendering scenes. This limitation can be a problem for users who want to optimize the rendering process depending on their hardware resources. Another disadvantage of Plasticity is the lack of a window indicator with a warning about unsaved changes when closing the program. This can lead to the loss of important work if the user accidentally closes the application without saving their changes. The presence of such a sign could significantly improve the usability. The program positions itself as a CAD application. CAD, or solid modeling, is a fundamentally different type of modeling when compared to polygonal modeling. Simply put, if we cut a model mentally, it will not be empty inside. Engineers and industrial designers for virtual prototyping of products that are subsequently planned to be produced use this technology. A significant advantage of Plasticity is its ability to efficiently model complex shapes, which makes it especially attractive to designers. Plasticity becomes an excellent choice for those looking for a convenient and efficient solution for working with complex shapes. One of the inconveniences of working with Plasticity is that, unlike Blender, after each action you have to confirm it by pressing the Enter key. This can slow down the modeling process and distract from the creative flow, as each action requires an additional step. In Blender, operations can be confirmed simply by clicking on an empty area in the 3D viewport, allowing you to focus on the creation process rather than having to constantly confirm actions. Another of disadvantages is the limited number of tools for creating different shapes compared to Blender. While you can create complex shapes in Plasticity, doing so often requires the use of additional tools and techniques, which can significantly slow down the modeling process. Blender, on the other hand, has a wider range of tools and features that allow you to create the desired objects quickly and efficiently. This makes Blender a more convenient and flexible option for people looking for quick and high-quality results. Also, chamfering in Plasticity sometimes works strangely and can cause some difficulties. Unlike Blender, where the process of chamfering is more intuitive and fast, in Plasticity, for some reason, in some cases, something prevents you from chamfering in quite logical places. This can slow down the workflow and distract from the creative process. In Blender, you can apply chamfers to models quickly and easily. Plasticity provides users with the ability to export models in various formats, allowing them to be integrated into other programs or used for further processing. Plasticity supports several popular formats for export, such as OBJ, STL. For convenient export of models from Plasticity to Blender, there is a special tool, Plasticity Blender Add-in. This add-in greatly simplifies the process of using models between the two programs, allowing users to easily and quickly export their work. Exporting models from Plasticity to Blender, as well as to other programs, can be accompanied by problems with mesh quality. Often there are situations when geometry loses its shape, unnecessary vertices or artifacts appear, which negatively affects further work with the model. To get rid of the problems, you will need retopology. You can use my settings to create a better model topology, but if they don't fit, I suggest you to change one and 2 points. Model retopology is a complex and time-consuming process that requires a significant time investment and in-depth knowledge of 3D modeling. This step is necessary to optimize geometry, improve topology, and prepare the model for animation or texturing. However, for beginners, this process can be too complicated and confusing, as it requires not only an understanding of the basics of modeling, but also skills in working with retopology tools. Therefore, if you're just starting your journey in 3D graphics, it's worth considering that retopology can be time-consuming and require more advanced knowledge, making Plasticity not the most suitable choice for beginners. Plasticity offers users the opportunity to try the program for 30 days for free. This is a great chance to evaluate all the features of the 3D modeling tool, familiarize yourself with its interface and functionality without any commitment. But once the trial ends, you can't start it again. When it expires, you can't even open your project. Your project simply don't open. Instead, you immediately see a window where you have to buy the rights to use them. At the moment, it costs $150 to buy the rights for home use. However, it's important to note that a major problem arises. You won't be able to transfer your models to other 3D programs. This means that all your efforts could be lost if you decide not to continue using Plasticity. Although the information about the need to purchase the full version of the program is present on the website, it is presented in a rather generalized way, and nowhere does it say that after completion you will need to buy the full version, because without it you will not be able to open your projects. Users should be careful and make a conscious choice to avoid unpleasant surprises in the future. To summarize, Plasticity 3D is a tool that is great for creating complex shapes and detailed models. However, it is important to note that Plasticity is more of an add-on to mainstream 3D modeling programs than a complete solution. For experienced 3D artists who are already using programs like Blender, Maya, or 3ds Max, Plasticity can be a useful tool for creating certain elements or details, but will not replace the core workflows. That's all for now. Thank you for your attention. Don't forget to put a like and subscribe to the channel. Good luck with your projects, and see you in the next video!